Hello, Ilian here. In this video, we're going to take a look at how to organize your devices and how to filter on them and how to view multiple devices' screen all at the same time. So let's take a look at that right now. So one thing that's really cool about MeshCentral is if you have a lot of devices to manage, there's different options for dealing with lots of devices at the same time. The UI has to be quite responsive, even if you have like hundreds of devices on your account, but also you want to be able to search for devices quickly, filter on them quickly, tag them, and be able to view multiple devices at the same time. So let's take a look at that. I'm going to start by having my trusty developer server right here. And it has, you know, about 20 different devices connected to it, not all powered up right now. So the first thing I want to point out is that you can click on filter here and filter devices by their name. So for example, if I type AMT or if I type desk, then it only shows me the devices with that string inside the name of that device. Now, I don't actually have to select this filter box. So I can be anywhere on the website, I can click anywhere, and I can type desk, and it will automatically just show up there. And then to clear this filter, you can hit escape, and it will just filter it out. So that's that easy. I can also filter by, for example, only online devices. And then in addition to online devices, I can type tiny and it will show me only the tiny device, the devices with the word tiny in it that also are online. I can hit escape, go back and try something else. So for example, only the offline devices, only devices with current sessions and so on and so forth. Now, another thing you've may notice here, you can right click on a device and say toggle star, and this puts a star next to the device, and then you can filter on star like this, or you can type just a star inside the filter box and that will show just the start devices. So if I have a few start devices here, and I can go here, type filter, hit the star, and boom, I only show those devices. So if you're actively working on a few devices and you just want to mark them to come back to those, then that's a super simple way to do that. You can also filter on only devices that have AMT and so on and so forth. Okay, now there's one interesting thing about MeshCentral, which is that devices, they can have an OS name and also a server name. So sometimes the operating system name doesn't match the name that you gave it on the site. So you can switch here between OS name and server name by just clicking this box. So that's an additional option. By the way, if you want to always keep that synchronized, there are some people who don't care about having a server name for their devices. They want the server names to always match the device name. In that case, you can click on a group and you can go on features. And then there's something called sync server device name to host name. And so I'm not going to do that. But if you do that, then the server, every time an agent connects, it will synchronize the two names. And so they won't be separate ever. Okay, so that's that. In addition to this view, by the way, before I end there, there's a whole bunch of other filters you can try. For example, I want to try user default, and then this will show me all the devices that the user default is logged in or was logged in at the last time I know. Or you can type u:default, that's the same. And actually, if you go to list view, it will show you the currently logged in user as a column here. And so if you want to just take a look at every device that has the user pi, then you can just type that u:, and the thing. Let's suppose I want to filter by IP address, 192.168.2.175. Boom, I type IP:, and the IP address of the device I want to find. For example, the group name, you can also group colon lab. This will only show you computers that are part of a group that has the word lab in it. And there's other things. For example, I can click on a device and I can add a tag. So for example, the tag is Bob here for Computer Central, and then I can put T colon tag, the tag name for Bob, and then the computers with that tag name will show up. So that is pretty cool. In addition, if you're in the list view here, there's a little gear on the upper right. You can click on that and you can select what columns you want to display on the right. So you can say no column at all and you have that, or you can pick the columns you are interested in. There's going to be more in the future. One of the interesting one is the MeshCentral Router links. These are links to that you can click on if you want to RDP to that machine and you have MeshCentral on your computer installed. That's part of another video. You click on that and you get instantly an RDP session with that device. So that's very nice. Now, the other two icons here on the right are interesting. The desktop and the other desktop here allow you to view the remote desktop of multiple devices at once. So here I'm going to select this icon, click connect all, and it says, are you sure you want to connect to 17 devices? I think anywhere above 10 devices, it will prompt you for this. So if I have less than, you know, if only I have a few machines, then it won't prompt. But over, I think 10, it will start prompting. And so now you can see that I'm seeing the display, the remote display of all these devices simultaneously. One of my computers is actually this one here is my own computer. So if I move the window, you'll see that it moves. And I could, this computer here is actually right next to me. So I can manage it. But what you can do is you can click on the screen to disconnect and reconnect, or you can click on the title bar to go full screen. And then I can, for example, open a File Explorer here. And then when I go back, it goes back right there. Now, one thing to note is that there's a setting here, and you can click on settings, and this is the settings for the resolution and the frame rate and quality for the capture in the thumbnail. So here, usually you put something pretty low, but when you click on a device and then you click on settings here, this is the resolution and the frame rate and the quality for the full screen version. So you want something a little better. And so when you go back, you'll see the screen kind of switch back to the lower resolution version. And then when you click on it, it will switch to the higher resolution version of your settings here. But in low resolution, you probably want to have a small scaling, like 12.5%. So the agent will scale down the remote desktop before sending it. The quality of the JPEG, you probably want it low. And the frame rate pretty slow. That means that you want like one frame capture every 10 seconds or something like that, because you're not, you know, it doesn't matter that it's that high quality. Now, another thing you'll notice is that some of these screens are stretched out. Like, for example, Central here, it's actually a dual monitor computer, but they're all kind of, regardless of the screen size, they're all kind of squished inside that rectangle, that same rectangle for all of them. Well, if you go on the right, the upper right, there's another desktop view, but this one, proportions of the screen are kept. And so here you see that this computer has double screen, and so it's wider, and some computers are narrower and so on, depending on their screen proportions. You can switch the size to medium, to large. And of course, the problem with the proportional one is that it keeps the proportion, but you know, all the squares are kind of not lined up. Where if you go back to the fixed width one, well, now they're all nicely organized, but obviously the screens are, you know, resized to fit that rectangle. So it's not that great. Another trick that's not often known, I'll go back to my normal view. You can select devices. For example, I'll select a few devices, like three or four of them. And I'll just check them with a checkbox. And then when you go to the multi-view, it will only show you the devices that were checked in the previous screen. So now I can do connect all, and there we go. So this is nice because if you don't want to look at all the devices, just a set of them, you just pick them and do that. Otherwise, you can opt to click only on the ones you want, but then you'll have black screens for the rest. So it's kind of better to go back here and to select the ones you want. By the way, another trick here is you can right click on the group name and say select all, or right click on a group name and select none. And so that's a quick way to select all the devices within a group. So if I want to see all the devices inside this group only, I do select all there, click there, and then I can say connect all, go, and it works. So that's cool. Now, another thing to note is that this is fairly stressful for the bitrate, especially if you're selected a high quality bitrate and you're watching multiple displays at the same time. So be mindful that it does stress the server. Also, if you have multiple people viewing the same computer at the same time, then you switching to lower resolution on this little thumbnail also switches their resolution to a lower resolution, unless you use the desktop multiplexer feature of MeshCentral. So that will be part of another video, but if you're using this multi-view a lot, or if you're using, if you're in situations where you have multiple people watching the same video at the same time, you may want to take a look at the MeshCentral multiplexer or desktop multiplexer feature. In any case, this was a quick overview of watching multiple displays on the same screen with MeshCentral, how to do filtering, different views, and so on. Hopefully this will help you manage lots of devices on your MeshCentral server pretty well. Thank you very much.